obviously bittersweet, you know, to know that I'm stepping away from the game. But, you know, it's hard to let something go that you love so much. When the season ended, I had every intention on coming back as the off season started and the weeks started to go by and I got closer to my conditioning program and all that stuff. The preparations that go through during the season and the more time consuming that it was taking for me to get ready to play and recover. And the final kicker for me was for the first time in my life, you know, when I was thinking about going back on the ice in August, for the first time, I was not looking forward to that. My body was just telling me that it was not ready to go at it again. Definitely want to stay involved in the game. When and where, we're not sure yet. But down the line somewhere, I'll definitely, be somewhere. You'll see me around sometime. I didn't even know. I didn't even realize I was going to be the first player retired. It's a great honor. When I found out yesterday, obviously that makes it even extra special and, a great honor. And looking forward to the night.
Yeah, you heard him mention right there that he is going to be the first player in Panthers history to have his number retired. So, I mean, look at the ranks right there. That tells you everything you need to know about just how great and why they decided to do this for Roberto Luongo. What do you think that means to a player and just really to the organization to tip their cap to all that he did for that group?
Well, it would be an incredible honor, of course. But I think it says how great you were as a player, but also speaks to your longevity in a market. And now he played a couple different times in Florida, but there's a real attachment between Roberto Luongo, his family, South Florida area. You saw what happened with the Parkland shootings and how affected he was by that. So I think for him, it would mean even more because he is so ingrained in the community. He will be at that rink. He will be able to travel through, see his jersey, the only jersey up in the rafters. And it's not about whether they should or they shouldn't. Of course they should. That's the no-brainer part of it. The easiest decision would be that they would retire his jersey. But just, I think for him specifically, because that is his home now. That's no longer a place where he played a long time. That's his home forever. That's where they're retiring. That's where his kids are going to go to school. That's where he's going to be. To have it happen there, because I think it probably will happen in Vancouver as well. But to have it happen there means that much more because he is so entrenched in that community.
Okay, so circle your calendar, March 7th, 2020, against Montreal. Roberto Luongo's number will be raised to the rafters in South Florida.